And where do you live these days?
New York.
New York? You said you're in school there?
Yes.
Where are you going to school?
I don't actually tell people that. But my name is Christopher Poole. I go by Moot on the internet, and 4chan is an anonymous image board, and it's divided into 48 different topics, ranging from anime, video games, photography. There is a lot of adult content on the site as well. And the site's gotten kind of notorious over the years for being a hotbed of memes and viral kind of activity. So I started the site when I was 15, and at that point, the content that was on the site initially had there were adult, there was pornography. It wasn't appropriate, so it wasn't something that I could share with my friends, it wasn't something that I could share with my family or my educators. And so very early on, I had to establish two identities. So I was like 19 or 20 before I started kind of coming out of my shell, so to speak. But I think that was really important early on, just to kind of protect myself. I'm a kind of private person. So the site that 4chan is based on is this Japanese image board. And in turn, the site that's based on is a Japanese text BBS. And they really pioneered this concept of anonymous posting. The conversation is raw, it's unfiltered, so you're getting like very truthful conversation. You judge somebody by the content of what they're saying and not their username, not their registration date. With identity, the discussion is mostly revolving around who is saying what and not what they're saying. So the exploits that the site kind of carries out, most of them are harmless, but there have been times where it crosses over from the online to the real life, kind of for the worse. At one point, kind of invasions became popular, so people would link to MySpaces and they'd get flooded with comments, and so that's something that's, it's regrettable that it happens, but when you do have that open community with a kind of very lax rule set, it's what you get. At this point, I really do stand behind anonymous communities. I use the term dinosaurs. Maybe that wasn't the best term, but I think they are certainly endangered because now we've just moved more and more towards persistent user identity. You've got a Twitter, you've got a Facebook. I guess you used to have a MySpace. People are putting just loads of information about themselves in these places, and we're becoming very comfortable with sharing very intimate details about our life. Like if somebody called you up on the phone and asked you all these things, you'd say hell no and hang up. But now we're flooding the internet with information about ourselves, and I think that's scary. And there's some comments that Eric Schmidt and Mark Zuckerberg made in the past few months just about kind of if we were to start now, we wouldn't have put such an emphasis on privacy, and that terrifies me.